Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Since President Biden took office, the price of gasoline has risen 55%. The price of electricity is up close to 30%. The price of groceries is up more than 20%. And the price of baby food is up 30%. Across Pennsylvania, families are feeling the effects of this inflation, and on average, they are paying an additional $70 a month for housing and an additional $240 a month for transportation. And since 2021, Pennsylvania households have spent over $20,000 more than they would have because of inflation. Recently, President Biden has attempted to claim that inflation was already at 9% annually when he took office, when in fact, it was only at 1.4%. What we are seeing is a president who has failed in his duty to protect American families. In central Pennsylvania, more than 100,000 families make less than $50,000 a year. Mothers shouldn't have to make a decision on whether to buy gasoline or buying school lunches. Parents should not have to worry at the kitchen table about paying their credit card bill or their rent. This is the reality that President Biden's radical spending spree has created over the past 4 years. It is time to return to fiscal sanity, and it is time to once again be responsible stewards of the taxpayer dollar. No matter what President Biden says in campaign speeches, inflation is the fault of his administration, and it's time to put a stop to the president's failed policies. Thank you. Mr. Speaker, as we recognize Memorial Day, we remember and honor the over 1.1 million Americans who have given their lives while serving in the armed forces. These men and women are heroes. An American story is not told without recognizing the price that they've paid to ensure our continued freedom. In Pennsylvania's 13th Congressional District, we understand the terrible price that this freedom costs. It was in Gettysburg, following the bloodiest battle of the Civil War, that President Lincoln said that we must take increased devotion to that cause for which they gave the last full measure of devotion. In the western part of our district, Cambria County is home to both United States Marine Corps Sergeant Michael Strength and U.S. Army Captain Harry Kramer. Sergeant Strength was one of the Marines who raised the American flag on Iwo Jima and was killed several days later during heavy fighting on that battle. Captain Kramer was a Green Beret, one of the Army's most highly trained warriors, who in 1957 would become the first American casualty during the war in Vietnam. These stories, they're very representative of the men and women across our country who have made the ultimate sacrifice. This weekend, amid graduation parties and summer barbecues, please take a moment to recognize these brave men and women who swore an oath to defend our nation and gave the ultimate sacrifice in the service of our freedoms. Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and I yield.